In this section, let's see how to create a horizontal alignment in Civil 3D. We'll also insert some information that helps define the Cohasset Ridge project area. Here I have gone to Google Earth and pulled up a map of the Cohasset Ridge area. The advantage of bringing in a geographical map like this is that we can see a lot of features that are not obvious in our model. For example, this scar identifies a line of large power poles that will run through our project. We can also see that there are some residences in our project area. We may want to be careful to avoid these with our alignment. So we pulled up the project area we are interested in modeling using Google Earth. And we will return to Civil 3D. To bring this image in, we want to create a new layer. So we'll go to Home, Layer Manager, and create a new layer. We'll call it Aerial Map GE. The GE is for Google Earth. We'll set the color to green, click OK, and we'll set this new layer as the current layer. Close the Layer Manager. And now we will select the Insert tab. And under the Insert tab, we can select Google Earth and pull down the menu. There are many options we could use, just the image or the surface. We just want to use the image because we already have a good terrain model. We'll superimpose the image on the terrain model we have created. We are prompted to select an insertion point, and we can just approximate where that might be. Click, and we just enter 0 for the angle of rotation. Now we can see that it brought the map in, but we need to adjust it to align it with our terrain model. One feature that we can identify is the roadway. We can use it to help us adjust the alignment. So let's go back to the Layer Manager. We will scroll down to the existing roads layer that has been turned off, and we'll turn it back on. Now we can easily identify an intersection on our model. We need to identify the same intersection on the Google Earth map. With careful inspection, we can see that it is right here. We want to move the image to match up with the intersection. We go to Modify and select the Move option or type Move in the command line. Again, we want to be careful to move just the image and not the model. So we select the boundary of the image and press Enter because this is the only object we want to move. We will select the base point to be the intersection in the image. It's hard to see, but right here is the roadway leading up, and this is where it intersects Kiefer Road. So we select that as the base point and move it to line up with the same intersection in the model. Now we can zoom out and look at some of the other features to check how the image and the model match up. We can see if we have to do anything else with our model. We can look at the roadway and see how the power lines run through the model. Up at the top here, it looks like the roadways are slightly out of alignment. We could rotate that just a little. But at least we have some more information. And a little editing will make this more useful for information on the alignment. With this extra information, we can begin to see where we would like to strike an alignment. For the new roadway following along Cohasset Ridge. The advantage of having the image on a separate layer is that we can turn it off. We'll go up to the layer manager. Since the layer is current, we can't turn it off. We'll set the zero layer as the current layer. Now we can go back to the aerial map GE layer and freeze it. Notice that the image has disappeared, and we can turn the image on and off as we need. To begin a horizontal alignment, we'll go back to the Home tab. And find the alignment pull-down on the ribbon. We'll select the Alignment Creation Tools option. We can name the alignment Proposed Roadway. And we want to add some description to remind ourselves. We are proposing a two-lane roadway. It is a proposed alignment, so all of the defaults will work just fine, and we can include all labels. We do want to modify the starting station. Let's set it to be 100 plus 00. Everything looks good, so click OK. And it brings up this toolbar. It allows us to choose from many different methods of design. I usually like to start by drawing tangents without the curves. The curves can be designed later and input as the information comes together. So select Tangent, Tangent, No Curve. And we'll start at the intersection of Cohasset and Kiefer Road. Let's keep the intersection alignment so that it is perpendicular to Cohasset and in line with Kiefer Road. We can see this is done by how we pull out the alignment. Click here. We'll bypass some of these drainage channels and we'll need to go up this hill. And now let's just strike a few alignments up here. They may not be the final alignment, but we'll just continue up to the other end and connect in with the existing road. So click right here and press enter now that we have the alignment done. This is truly preliminary. We can change it at this point simply by clicking on the alignment. Notice that we have all these grips to choose from to make some adjustments. We'll zoom in and make sure we select the alignment. And now we can begin editing the alignment to fit the design criteria. Next thing we should notice is that the alignment is labeled. As we instructed it, all of the stations are labeled beginning at station 100 plus 00. But right now it's not very legible. We need to increase the label size. So let's go down to the status bar. We can select scales by clicking on this. Let's try a scale like 1 inch equals 500. Notice the text is resized for a particular scale. The text gets larger because the scale is now 1 inch equals 500, which is actually a very small scale. but we still have too many stations labeled. So we need to select the alignment, right click, let's right click up here. It pulls out the menu here, and we would like to edit the alignment labels. Select that. These are all of the stations that are being labeled right now. 100-foot increments with tick marks at 50-foot increments. This is way too much for the alignment. So let's select this increment and change it to an increment of 1,000 feet. And set the minor ticks at 500. We may modify this later, but this is a good place to start. Hit apply, and right away we can see the improvement in the clarity of the alignment labeling. The next thing we need to do is place some curves in here. We'll have to go to the Highway Design Manual to determine the correct curve radius criteria. With that information on how to design the curves, we'll use the free curve fillets between two entities and give the radius. Let's look at how to do one. It asks for the first entity, so let's select the tangent going into the point of intersection, the PI. The next entity is the one that leaves the point of intersection. It asks if the curve solution angle is less than 180. It's asking for the delta, which is less than 180 here. So we'll press enter. The default radius is 200, but let's use 2000. This distance should be verified with the Highway Design Manual. We can see that it has put the curve in, and now it's asking for the next tangent. Notice that where I select the tangents, I select it close to the PI. As before, we select tangents entering and leaving the PI. Press enter because delta is less than 180. And for the curve radius, this time we'll try 5,000. Now we can go through the entire project this way. When we're done, we can just press enter and it will solve and restation along the curves. We can go through the rest of the project, putting in the curves, and we see that the stationing will follow the curved alignment. Now we are ready to create profiles. This is a good point to save at.